Hey, yo, it's a big deal today. We got a Rarefied Air representative, original RareAir representative, Dr. LaFlow.
What's up, what's up?
I was baptized in Hennessy and urges of my enemies. A blind man told me that my soul glows bright.
My man, it's his first day out, you know what I mean? First day in Phoenix. Just pick my man up from the airport today. You know, starting his trek out here through the desert, straight out of the tropics.
Get some of this West Coast weed.
Exactly, yes, yes.
Blowing on that papaya right here. Beautiful trill, you know what I mean? Got all types of shit with me. Records, spray paint, shit, anything under the sun.
I just found out your ass tagged. I didn't even know you tagged.
I do.
Yeah, bro, when'd you get into, so you just like more of an artist over per se? Instead of yourself.
So I used to, when I first started tagging, I tagged with Flow. I've been tagging since before I started making beats. So when I started making beats, I needed to pick a name. Microphone and this thing right here. So I was like, I need a name. So I was like, I'll do Flow. But I always wanted something with doctor. That's like the way doctor sounds.
Yeah.
And Dr. Flow just sounds, it don't quite have that nice ring to it. So then I threw the love in.
Yeah, the love always adds a little elegance, you know what I mean?
Dr. LaFlow.
And then what is it, the prescriber of what?
He's arrived to prescribe the vibes.
Hey, that's the vibes. There we go.
I'm arrived to prescribe the vibes.
You know what I'm
Take
saying?
Two and call me in the morning.
Exactly, bro.
So you do a lot, bro. So you've made a lot of beats for us over there. You were actually like the first producer that I actually like locked in and worked with.
Yeah, that was a minute ago on SoundCloud.
10 years ago, damn near. Shit in the vault, you know what I mean? That's not even on the Spotify's and
that whooping
like that.
Cough.
You know what I mean? Whooping cough, you know, heads or tails, a lot of that shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
my man was cooking up the album covers for it.
That's
what I'm saying. He does the album covers. Yeah. He makes beats. You also rap. We just wanted a little on the spot earlier over up the street.
A street light streaking past fast on a hot night. Breathe deep, hit it with the left, and I got right. Get paid so much in the safe, it can't lock tight. Low key, I don't want my life in the spotlight.
If y'all couldn't already tell, you know what I mean?
No,
So what do you? What would you consider yourself? You're a rapper, producer. You're more than that.
I mean, producing is definitely what I do. Like first and foremost, that's like as far as music is concerned. Producer first, you know, and then after that, I mean, rapping. I kind of started doing it because I'm just making beats. I was like, you know, I'm gonna try and write something. Exactly. Yeah. Gotta work a little something on them. So I like doing that, but I like collaborating with artists more. Like y'all, of course. So
y'all work with music videos even type shit.
Yeah.
Yo, shout out to the flow when it's Florida laboratory. Call the storytory, since Capone and Ari go report. We not top 40, we more shape 45. Need shorties with thick thighs and something sporty to drive.
I wanna hear you talk about the chrome crystals. People haven't heard the album. You gotta go listen to the album. But it's more than just an album. It's an audio visual.
I have a visual side for Chrome Crystals, which was the last album I did. So I put that album out, then I was trying to figure out what I wanna do next with this.
Right.
You know, I always just put on music. Instead of going and working on something new, I was like, I'm gonna take my time and, you know, push this as much as I can. So I've made a visualizer for, like a full-length visualizer for every song, start to finish,
like to 30, go along with the album. Minutes
about to say. Yeah. It's a whole album, like 36 minutes, it's the whole thing. So I haven't made, and I just haven't widely released it yet. It's out there, it's been floating around, people have seen pieces of it. Yeah, you know, and like I've individually released pieces of it, so I'm just trying to figure out a good way to really put it out, you know?
Right.
Like, I could just put it on YouTube.
But you want to give them the full experience.
You know, well, I want to do something special for it, because I feel like if you spend like a year and you just work on something, like, you know.
Yeah.
You want to present it nicely, you know?
Like, you're a man of ideas, a man.
Exactly.
I spend most of my life hanging around crummy joints with a bunch of punks, drinking the beer, eating the hash and the hot dogs and watching the other people go off to Florida while I'm sweating out, I'm gonna pay the plumber. I done time when I stood up, but I can't take no more chances. next time it's gonna be me going to Florida.
Yeah, and we've talked off camera and stuff, you know, about a lot of movies and stuff. Would you say that's a big inspiration for how you come across?
Definitely. I mean, I've been into movies probably almost as long as I've been into, well, maybe not, but almost as long as I've been into music. So I definitely approach it with like a I guess in my mind. Like even when I make albums now, I make them in a, maybe not in the sense you think of it as a movie, but it's like meant to be played like start to finish. Like it's a whole thing. I don't really just think of it as like individual tracks. Yeah. I try and...
You still make albums.
Yeah, it's albums. Like it's a full experience. But I think that comes from me being into movies. I'm like, I like complete, you know, it's a whole story, you know, beginning, middle, end, just give me the whole thing, themes, all that shit, you know. And I think it, when you approach it like that, you can... You know, at least I know when I work on albums, I kind of think like, all right, I want it to have this kind of feel to it, and then I'll kind of make it work around that, you know, whatever, however I'm feeling at the time.
How you kind of want to make it cinematic. You say you see it cinematically, and I respect that. I actually have like a concept thing myself that I'm working on to do the same. So when you do it, are you looking at it like, so who would be like a director that you would say like kind of helps you mold you into what kind of cinematic experience you do musically? What kind of direct, like when I think of, say, Quentin Tarantino, he has a certain kind of sound when I think about his shit. Or say even like Kevin Smith even. I know he's had local New Jersey bands do shit on his soundtracks for that actual purpose.
Okay.
Yeah. Is there anybody like that gives you that kind of, it gives you a feeling that like you can do the sound?
I would say, the Oceans movies that Steven Soderbergh did.
I rapped over some of that
shit. Those three movies, that was like a big... There was a time where I was like, yo, I want like my music to kind of sound like these movies.
Real jazzy.
I would say that was probably like my biggest, as far as like just music-wise. Like,
I can see it, though.
That was a good, like, I was like a relationship I wanted to, you know, make in my head.
I can see that, though.
So what's your concept thing though?
So mine is more of an actual anime. Mine is from, so I watched Evangelion over quarantine, right? And I watched it with like a fresh lens of being like a motherfucking actual adult. And man, that shit resonated with me in a certain way. So what I'm doing is I'm navigating through each track, each element of kind of how it went through its stages through like the hero cycle.
Okay.
You know, I know Star Wars is the OG one, but like it took its own to that, and I'm like doing that through songs. So I have like 7 tracks. I'm like putting like each one has a certain type of feel and aesthetic to it. I want to have. I kind of feel you on that.
Yeah, so that's what you're saying. You like, you take something, you have like a visual for it, and you try and like...
Right. The album of lost art, bro. Honestly, it's a lot of playlists, a lot of just singles and shit, which I love niggas who can make music and just pump it out. Like, I love Chief Keef and motherfuckers can do that, but like, that's an Outkast punch, my favorite. Because of that, you know?
Solid.
Women Eye and shit, man. Like, come on, dog. Like, dude, you can listen to that whole thing. That's a whole experience.
Exactly.
Yeah, Spodidodiopolis hits different when you listen to
It kind of tells a story. You have an album like that where it's like something you just listen to, like, top to bottom?
One of my favorite albums, I always say this in general when people ask about LaFlow. One of my favorite albums, period, is I think it's Dr. Noise number 4. Which is one that has like the Waka Flocka.
Waka
Flocka, Vibrant Squad.
You mentioned that you were a producer before. You're saying it's the bread and butter. Also, to be more specific, you're a particularly gifted remixer.
Thank you. I love doing remixes. Yeah. And that's also something I got something coming.
Oh, okay.
I'm working on number 7. I figured out how to do it.
You can't take that bitch nowhere. Ugh. I look better with no hair. Ugh. Ain't no sign I can't smoke hair. Ugh. Yeah. Give me the chance and I'll go there.
Because one thing I realized, which I wish rappers and like artists would do a lot more now, put on acapellas. Like you know, like back when like they release a single, on the record you'd be like, you know, A side and B side, you have like the instrumental and the acapella and like the radio mix and shit.
Yeah.
So like when I first started doing remixes, that's how I got most of it. It was like older songs, like 90s, 2000 releases, just drop studio quality acapellas like that. And I even remember I wish I bought it when at the time. Jay-Z put out two whole acapella albums, like commercially, straight up, like Jay-Z acapella.
I know, that was
studio
smart.
Quality. Like, here, take these.
Because that's a smart.
And I'm like, I don't know why rappers don't do that anymore.
And you managed to give everything, like, your real, like, particular style to it. Like, it was very, yes. One of the most distinct production styles I've ever heard. Thick. And it's always been like that. How did you, like, develop that? Like, it don't even really feel like it's, like, influenced by, yeah, like, nothing. Like, how did you even go about the way you process your vocal samples and, like, okay, even though yeah, your instrument samples, like, they have this, like, warble to them, kind of.
Yeah,
like,
yeah. So
it almost sounds like you're always pulling from the same album, but, like, you're not. Okay, like, yeah, you know yeah, what yeah, I mean? Yeah. Like, it's all, but it all sounds like you, like.
Because, all right, well, basically what I'll do is I'll, the way I found early on when I first was like,
you don't gotta give away the song.
Yeah, I don't give away the song.
You know, yeah, you're gonna say, like, how did you end up discovering that? Because it's, well, been like that for a long time. Yeah, it's not nothing new for you.
Actually, when I first started making beats, I was like really into EDM at the time, and I was like, so I was really trying to make beats like that. Like, I was like throwing in like dubstep noises, right, and like I was doing like making synth noise and all this stuff. I have like two, like my first two beat tapes, which I never like, I didn't like put them out. It's like totally something different. And then but that was me just trying to find my sound, I guess. And then you know, I always like working with samples, so I like mix the samples with the synths and all that. And then eventually I really started like digging for records and everything. I think I bought a turntable around that time, so I was like going to the record shops and digging everything. And then like I kind of got into this, yeah, this organic sound where it was almost kind of like my intention was basically, I was like, all right, my whole thing is gonna be just all samples. Like, I'm not gonna use any synths, not gonna like do anything. All I'm gonna do is just manipulate samples and make beats for that. Uh-huh. So through that, you know, I kind of found like a way to manipulate them that I liked and that, you know, it sounded interesting. And you know, like that like you said, like that warbled sound and everything. And I found
it almost sounds like a almost reminds me of like a turntable or vinyl, like falling
yeah,
apart.
And that's
or
that's
something. It's like a very kind of like yeah, has a real decayed kind
of. And part of it is because a lot of what I use is like vinyl samples, like it's not like a YouTube rip or anything, it's like straight vinyl. So I think that has a lot to do with it too, because I've used like samples from the, you know, vinyl and, you know, stuff from YouTube and like just shit I recorded off my phone and everything. And I find that the vinyl, it has like a sound that you can't really match it.
So yeah, you don't do splice?
Not your bag at all.
What's the difference for you? Like, about, like, you know, cause I feel like you, because to me there's something different about, like, you know, you have a relationship with the record or the movie you pull it from, or there's more of like a DNA to the creative process and even yeah, the results at that point.
Yeah. And
do
I
you
think,
feel like you agree with that?
Yeah, I would say, because I think with each, every time I make a track or a beat or something, I think I'm trying to say something with it. You know, it's like it's a style of music where it's not lyrical, really. You know, like I'm not really like
yeah,
speaking out of it or
yeah,
anything like that.
So
but
you're extra expressive.
Yeah, exactly. So every sample, the song titles, and all that, it's all intentional. And like, I'm sure like every artist feels that way. Like
right,
there's a reason. Yeah, there's a reason you pick everything and all that. So I think that, you know, when you say that, I think that like that thought process, it comes out in the final product, even if like the listener might not be totally aware of it. Like, you might be like, oh, okay, I totally get the metaphor of this, or oh, I get what he, you know, what he must have been thinking with this. But you feel
even if you never get it, even if you play it 100 times, you know, or it might be some personal to him that the audience never understands. Like he says,
yeah,
it still comes across.
There.
You still feel it. Like, mm-hmm,
like there's some, exactly. You still feel that there's some emotion there. So I think when you make music, like coming from, as cliche as not coming from the heart, you know, instead of like, all right, I'm gonna just sit down and just make a beat, like, you know, mm-hmm, I'm gonna just loop this piano and throw some drums on it and boom. Then, you know, you get a different experience, you know, yeah, for the listener. Because I think people can kind of tell when, you know, kind of what I call like a microwave beat, like it's just something that you just.
Yeah, just
throw together real quick, no really thought. Like, I know me, like, and I, like, when I sit down and make beats, like, if you sat me down and, like, you know, gun to my head to make a beat right now, I could do it. Like, easy. I could give you something. But I know when I sit down, like, I might play around with something, listen to a tracker, and I just don't feel anything. Like, I'm like, oh, I could sample this, but it just doesn't give me that feeling. Like, oh shit, this is it. So I keep searching till I find something, and then I'm like, oh, like it's something that you kind of just know. Like, you know, you hear something and you're just like, no, like, oh, this is like heat right here.
Right.
And you just build with that, and then, you know, you just kind of keep going with songs that give you that feeling, and I think that's how you end up with better music.
Which you actually stand behind.
Yeah, exactly. Because, like, there's a bunch of shit that I gotta make and throw out. There's sometimes I sit down for an hour or two, nothing. Like, I just can't, not feeling it. But, and the other times I might sit down, smoke a blunt, 10 minutes later, I'm like, oh shit, like, this is a banger right here. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I feel like, It's really about quality over quantity and how much time you put into your craft and knowing, like, hey, you gotta kind of set a certain threshold for yourself and be like, all right, am I gonna put this out just to do it, or am I gonna do it because, like, I actually feel like this is something good, you know?
Well, shit, I mean, it's been working so far.
Yeah.
It's gonna continue working with us. Now that we got my man here,
yes,
you know,
I'm
what
very
I mean?
Excited. I'm out here.
We got Arnim in the crew. Yes, so, you know what I mean?
Behind that
fire, there's gonna be coming to a new level.
Yeah.
Yes. 2023, 2024.
RareAir, we're gonna take it to a whole new level. New Rarefied.